Welcome to another Mathologer video. You're here for the mysterious iris in the thumbnail, aren't you? Piqued your interest, huh? Well, let's chase it down. Start with any old triangle. At the corner opposite the red side, grow two copies of that red side like this. Then opposite the blue, the same thing, grow two copies of the blue side. And there, two greens. A triangle with whiskers. Cute! Now, doesn't matter what triangle we start with, those six endpoints, what's special about those six points? Can you guess? Those six points are, you got it? Yes, those six points lie on a circle. Really? Sure, if it was going to be anything, that it was a circle, but it's still pretty surprising, isn't it? Three random points usually determine a circle. On the other hand, four random points usually don't lie on a circle, and of course it's even less likely for random 5 or 6 points to lie on a circle. Anyway, this miraculous 6-point circle is called Conway's circle, named after its discoverer, the legendary mathematician John Conway. Conway was a mathematics professor at Princeton University, a certified genius, and the inventor of many ingenious mathematical games that also became incredibly popular outside mathematics. For example, chances are, even if you're not a mathematician, that you're familiar with Conway's bizarre game of life. There, you've seen this sort of alien 2D life before, right? That's due to Conway. Anyway, little miracles like this circle would constantly pop up in conversations with John Conway, and if he deemed you worthy, you could expect to be challenged to come up with a proof on the spot. I'll show you the ultimate super pretty proof next, a proof which involves the iris in the title of this video. I'll also tell you about some exciting new life beyond Conway's circle, in particular the beautiful windscreen wiper theorem will have you smiling next time it rains. However, if you consider yourself worthy, then before you watch the rest of the video, accept Conway's challenge and try to come up with a proof of your own. Report on your efforts in the comments. Here John Conway looks a little bit like St. John, doesn't he? Anyway, did you come up with a proof? No? Not a problem. Not an easy one. Want a hint? Okay, here's one. Whenever you deal with a would-be circle, what's the first thing you should be looking for? Yep, it's heart. Of course, the center of the circle. And how do we locate the center? Well, for example, by shrinking the circle. There, shrink. Shrink, 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 shrink. There, that's the center. But wait a minute. Before the circle collapsed into the center, did you notice something remarkable? No? Did you blink? Let me show you again. Ready? This time, watch closely. There, shrinking, shrinking, shrinking. You saw this time, right? Just before the circle collapses to a point, it appears to simultaneously touch all three sides of the triangle. There, rewind a bit. That's really cool, isn't it? And so it looks like the whiskered triangle actually gives birth to an iris and not just a circle on the outside. Equipped with this extra clue, does the triangle lover in you want to give proving all this another go? Pause the video if you like, but we'll keep going and chase down a pretty proof ourselves. Let's start with a ring and highlight one of its chords. Then it's clear that all such chords have the same length. Obvious, right? Also, the point where the chord touches the inner circle is the exact midpoint of the chord. There. Also obvious. Alright, what this means is that if we start with a circle and three equal struts with highlighted centers, then if we arrange these struts around the circles like this, we can be sure that the six ends are on the circle. That together with the one we started with, forms an iris. Still all crystal clear, right? So, to prove that the whiskered triangle really extends to an iris, all we have to show is two things. First, we have to show that these three struts are of equal length. Well, pretty damn obvious, right? They're all made of one red, one blue, and one green each. Okay. And the second thing we have to show is that the points at which the struts touch the inner circle are the centers of the struts. How do we do that? Well, here's an idea. Let's swivel this highlighted horizontal strut around one of the corners of the triangle. That orange corner there. Okay, go, swivel. Since the two blue ends are of equal length, the two struts will end up in perfect superposition. Nice. But did you notice something extra nice? There. Looks like the contact points with the circle also land on top of each other. Why is that? So another look at the starting configuration. Well, these two distances here are clearly equal. This means that not only do the two struts end up superimposed perfectly, but also the two points of contact do. All right, now color the strut like this. So what we want to show is that the magenta is exactly as long as the aqua. Ready for a nice aha moment in three stages? Here we go. Stage one, swivel around the right corner. Perfect coincidence. Stage two, swivel around the top corner. Of course, perfect coincidence again. Stage three, perfect coincidence yet again. And overall, the aqua and the magenta parts have switched places, which shows that the aqua is exactly as long as the magenta. You like this? Very nice, isn't it? And of course, the same is true for the other two struts, which then shows that the six points are on a circle. And we're done. We have confirmed the existence of Conway's iris. But let me show you a second way to see that the two parts of our strut are of equal length. There. Remember that these two distances here are equal, as are these and these. But then remember, two copies of the bottom side of our triangle become the whiskers on top. Okay, then those two become the whiskers on the right. Okay, and finally, those are the whiskers on the left. Now let's highlight the horizontal strut again. Here comes the magic. Ta-da! Same length again. Not bad either, don't you think? Now let's have a vote. Did you like the swivel proof best, that one? Or did you like the coloring proof best? Before you continue with the video, record your vote in the comments. I actually trialed a version of this presentation in one of my classes at university, and there most of my students voted for the coloring proof. Fair enough, the coloring proof is definitely quicker. However, apart from also being very pretty, the swiveling proof has another major thing going for it. The swiveling proof actually spawns a beautiful new way to generate the iris that even the most hardcore triangle lovers among you will not be aware of. A new way that makes Conway's static iris contract and expand like a real life iris, like one of my own. Yeah. That's the next chapter of our video. Let's go for a second round of swiveling. This time, focus on the magenta endpoint of the swiveling strut. That one there. Ready? Okay. There, there. Aha, as you can see, as we swivel, the magenta endpoint cycles through all six endpoints of the whiskers, our special 6 points. And when you look at the swiveling strut, aren't you reminded of windscreen wipers in action? There, windscreen wiper, another one, another one. And so just focusing on the windscreen wipers gives a second very intriguing way of generating our 6 points. For easy comparison, here again is Conway's first way, triangle, then whiskered triangle, and there are the 6 points. Now, second way, triangle, then infinite whiskers, place a copy of the red side to locate the first point, and then find the remaining points by this beautiful windscreen wiper action there. Wipe, 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 wipe. 6 times. And there's the circle again. And its smaller in-circle baby sister. But now, the super nifty extra aspect of the second way of generating the iris is that it turns out to be a special case of the windscreen wiper theorem, which gives birth to infinitely many more irises. Here are a few of these irises. Okay, there's the one that we just had. There's another one. There's another one. There's another one, there's another one, there's a really, really small one. Intrigued? Well, then let me show you where those other irises come from. Start again with the special point on the bottom strut. That one there. But now, instead of this special starting point, let's start with another point on the horizontal. This one here, a bit further in, going there. Now unleash the windscreen wipers again. There, 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 there. We get 6 new points that are also irised. There. And all this actually works for any starting point whatsoever on the horizontal line. Even points on the triangle side itself work. Have a look. There, go in. Huh. How wonderful is that? So Conway's circle theorem is really just a special case of the very general windscreen wiper theorem, which says this. Start with any point on the whiskers of a triangle. Then windscreen wipering the point gives 6 points on a circle that together with the inner circle of the triangle form an iris. I should mention that the full windscreen wiper theorem can be proved by swiveling exactly as we did for Conway's special case. So my students got it wrong. The swiveling proof is in fact a superior proof. Yep, I should really go back and fail them all now. Just kidding. I've not been able to establish the exact chronology of the discoveries of Conway's circle theorem and the windscreen wiper theorem. Conway's circle theorem only achieved some fame after John Conway died of COVID in 2020, when Matt Barker mentioned a circle in his tribute blog for John Conway. Since then, a number of different proofs for Conway's circle theorem have surfaced, and what I presented today was distilled from proofs by Colin Beveridge and Paul Farrel. Then it was only pointed out last year by Michael de Villiers that Conway's circle theorem is a special case of the windscreen wiper theorem, which has been known since at least 1994. Anyway, I'll put links to whatever I've been able to find chronology-wise in the description of this video. If you happen to have more information about who discovered what and when, or some anecdotes involving either theorem, please let me know in the comments. Actually, windscreen wiper theorem is my name for something that was originally known by the not so terribly catchy name side divider theorem. I also made up the name Conway's iris. If YouTube has taught me anything, then it's the fact that having a good title or name can be the key to your video or theorem being a success. Okay, to finish off, let me show you a dramatic rendering of the windscreen wiper theorem involving some raindrops and a very unexpected twist at the end. What do you think of my rainy day rendering of the windscreen wiper theorem? Nice, right? But where's the twist that I promised you? Well, have a look at this. After all that wiping, there is still water in the iris. Well, not that it matters as far as anything I've said so far is concerned, but think about it for a second. Those windscreen wipers were of different lengths. This means that the wiped area cannot be a circle. But if it's not a circle, what sort of shape is the wiped area? Well, let's have a close look. Not a circle. But just like the circle, this weird curve contains the 6 special points. For comparison, here's the circle. Interesting, isn't it? What's even more interesting is that this weird curve turns out to be one of those curious curves of constant widths that I already reported on in an earlier video. What this means is that if you wedge the curve in between 2 parallel lines, like that, then no matter which way the parallel lines are oriented, the distance is always the same. There, same distance. So in a way, this curve, just like the circle, has the same diameter in all directions. Among other things, this means that when you rotate the curve inside a square of just the right size, it will touch all sides of the square at all times. It's pretty magical, isn't it? If you like this, check out that other video. Really beautiful and totally unexpected, don't you think? And here's a little puzzle for you to finish things off for today. Ready? Which is larger, the diameter for Conway's circle or that of the weird curve? Let us know what you think in the comments. Until next time.